2006, 20% of deaths in the United States were from heart disease. 23.1% died from cancer, and 5.7% from a stroke. But at Faith Presbyterian Hospice in Irving, Texas, 0% died of loneliness.
Our quest was to help the terminally ill cope maximally with their condition and prepare for death.
Our Faithful Presence program is a program that my husband Don and I brought to Faith Presbyterian Hospice. It's a program where we record family members onto a CD talking about three things. One, recounting fond memories and experiences they've shared with them. Two, talking about the qualities they admire and respect about them. And three, if they're comfortable to tell them that they love them. We then take those recordings, we edit them, we back it up with music of their choice. It can be secular or religious. And we produce a CD, and that CD is presented to the patient and all family members.
If family members could provide comforting words for the dying person to listen to while awaiting death, that would be good for the dying person as well as the family. In the professional community, our program was well regarded. Psychiatrists and psychologists who sent patients to us for this kind of care were delighted to hear that we really helped out. Life gives us opportunities to shift from the non-workable way to the workable way, and that is crisis. The typical recipient of the Faithful Presence program shifts then from despair and wondering, what was this all for? What's to come? How can I cope not only with the aspect of this illness, but with the big picture? It enables that person to shift from that to, my life did have meaning. I did make a difference. I can have closure. Yeah, I made some mistakes, but I did a lot of good things too, and I can accept what is.
Working at a hospice took a major toll on, I think, a lot of the workers there. You get sad with the family and you feel like you're a part of what they're doing, and you start to miss the person too and grieve with them a little bit, of course. At least I feel that really good hospice workers at least give themselves over a little bit.
Pee-wee was one of our patients who was admitted in January of 2006. His family had been explained the Faithful Presence program and offered to participate. When I first talked to Pat Jones, who's Pee-wee's daughter, she was particularly excited about the program and participating. But her daughter, Christy, who was grown, was a little reticent about it.
Initially, and I think that's my first thought, was I can't do this with my kids. It's too hard. They're going to see me cry. I don't want to do this with them. This is private. And I think part of this is because I'm an emotionally private person. And so it was me putting myself out on a limb, because I'm used to, you hide that from your kids.
It was a little bit of a challenge for them to relax and get into the program, but they did a beautiful job. And in the end, they will all tell you it's the most important thing they've probably done in their lifetime up to this point.
I was working on the editing, and I got the phone call that he was going and I needed to get there right away. So I scooped up what we had and finished it really quick and ran over there. And Pee-wee hadn't spoken in 3 days, and he was really agitated, and he was kind of not sure what to do and where to go.
When he heard his great-granddaughter Charlie sing Amazing Grace, he raised his arms up to the corner of the room and tried to sing along with her.
How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
So what the Faithful Presence program enables families to do is solve the timing problem. It enables them to say the unsaid to make it said, to put it in the space, not only for one another to hear, but for the dying person to hear before the person passes away.
I would love to see all hospices get involved in this Faithful Presence program. My goal would be to see every family take advantage of the time and the venue and the form that this program allows for their family to get together, to feel supported, to offer closure for both parties, and to bring meaning to that life that's ending.
I listen to that tape at least once a week. I mean, I turn it on and I maybe just play my daughter singing, or I listen to my grandmother's talking to him or my mom. And to me, it's funny because I still have a way to connect with him.
I never knew of anything like this. I've never heard of anything like this. And even people that have had hospice all say they've never heard of a hospice group doing something like this.
I don't know that I will be as pained the next time I have to go through this process.
I don't think I could have made it through his death if I hadn't done it.
But now I see.
I love the feeling.
I definitely love the feeling.
I love you, Pee-wee.
I love you.
I love you more than you'll ever know.
We love you, Pee-wee.
Pee-wee, you know I love you, don't you?